Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss another topic, that is the concept of electric flux density, and we will try to solve one problem on E bar due to line charge and surface charge. So let me take a review on what we covered in the previous lecture. In the previous lecture we covered the E bar formula due to point charge. This was the E bar formula due to line charge, due to surface charge, and due to volume charge. And we had a detailed discussion how we got this particular formula, these three formulas, and how this Q can be replaced with rho L dl, rho S ds, and rho V dv. So everything we have covered in the previous lecture, and we discussed that the first application of this E bar concept or Coulomb's law is to get E bar due to infinite line charge distribution. So that formula is E bar equal to rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon 0 r ar cap. Okay, this rho means it is a cylindrical system parameter, so we generally call it as r, and this is ar cap unit vector. So this derivation is remaining, but I will cover this later on. So just at this moment you remember that this formula is for infinite line charge distribution, E bar due to infinite line charge. Okay, that means line charge is having some charge on it, okay, and due to this charge distribution E bar we get this. Then after that we discuss the derivation of E bar due to infinite surface charge. We assume that infinite surface is kept in xy plane. It is infinite in all directions, okay, in all these directions. And we assume that one point is there on z axis where we want to find out E bar, okay. And we also assume, third assumption was, this total surface, infinite surface, is assumed to be made up of small differential surfaces. So this one is one of the ds, this ds is one of the differential surface, there could be another ds here, there could be another ds here, likewise, and so on. So at the end we found that the E bar is found to be rho s upon 2 epsilon 0 az cap for our assumptions. In general the E bar is equal to rho s upon 2 epsilon 0 an cap. Okay, where an is unit vector, any vector, unit vector normal to the given sheet. That means wherever our infinite surface charge is kept, you have to draw the perpendicular to that, and whatever direction you get, that will be the direction here. And now today we are going to solve one problem on electric field intensity. Okay, so what the problem is, planes x equal to 2 means constant x equal to 2 surface, okay. You can recall back the Cartesian coordinate system in which we discuss that if it is a x axis, if it is a y axis, if it is a z axis, then if x equal to 2 is here on x axis, then if I introduce a plane surface like this, plane surface at x equal to 2, then it is called as x equal to 2 plane. Why? Because all points on this plane will have x coordinate 2, because it is cutting the x axis at x equal to 2. It is cutting the x axis at x equal to 2. That's why all the points, x coordinate of all the points on this surface will have x equal to 2 coordinate. Hence, this surface is now called as x equal to 2 plane. Similarly, if we move this plane surface at x equal to 3, then it will become x equal to 3 plane. And remember, this plane is infinite everywhere, in top direction, in back or bottom direction, in front direction, as well as back direction. So x equal to 2 plane. Second plane given in the problem is y equal to minus 3 plane. So y equal to minus 3 plane, suppose this is x axis, y axis, this is positive y axis. So on the down backward side there would be negative y axis. So negative y axis, so the plane surface is cutting at y equal to minus 3, okay. And both the surfaces are charged surfaces. That means there is a charge, they carry some charge. What charge they carry? Here it is mentioned in the problem. X equal to 2 surface carries a charge of 10 nanocoulomb per meter square. Okay, that means it is rho s, surface charge density, rho s1. You can call it as rho s1. and second surface y equal to minus 3 carries 15 nanocoulomb per meter square. So you can denote it by rho s 2. That means surface charge density of second surface. Okay. If the third charge distribution is also given, if the line charge, now line charge is also given, where is the line is placed? Line is placed at x equal to 0 comma z equal to 2. Okay. Surface is always mentioned only with one coordinate, and line, whenever you want to mention a line, whenever you want to describe a line, it has two coordinates. Remember this point, this is very important. When you describe a point, it requires three coordinates. When you describe a line, you require two coordinates. And when you describe a surface or plane, you require only one coordinate. This you have to remember always. So how many charge distributions are given? Two plane surfaces are given, which are charged with rho s1 and rho s2. And third kind of charge given is line charge. Location is given, and it is carrying how much charge? 10 pi nanocoulomb per meter. That means it is a, what is given? Rho L. So rho L is given, line charge density is given, 10 pi nanocoulomb per meter. So how many charges are given in this problem? Three charges are given in this problem, and due to these three charges, you are asked to find out, calculate E bar at 1 comma 1 comma minus 1 due to this three charge distribution. So how would you solve this problem? Obviously, the total electric field intensity due to these three charge distributions, we will assume that total E bar will be equal to E1 bar plus E2 bar plus E3 bar. This E1 bar will be due to first surface, E2 bar will be due to second surface, and E3 bar will be due to this line charge. Okay, so you have to compute these individual components and add them. Once you add, then you will get total E bar. Okay, so next point is which formula you can use. Obviously, you are having two plane surfaces, that means you have to use, for to calculate E1 bar and E2 bar, you need to calculate which formula? This is the problem. Okay, sorry for the disturbance. So in order to calculate E1 bar and E2 bar, which formula you need to use? Obviously, you need to use this formula. This is the general formula, okay? For any sheet of charge, any surface, any plane. Sheet means plane, plane surface. So rho s upon 2 epsilon 0 an cap. And what is an cap? An cap is a vector, unit vector, which is perpendicular, normal to the given sheet, given surface, given plane. So whatever it may be, an cap, anything, an cap can be x cap, ay cap, az cap. For Cartesian, for cylindrical, it can be ar cap, fi cap, az cap, and so on. So you have to identify, generally rho s is given, 2 is constant, epsilon 0 is constant, only you have to find out an cap. An cap is nothing but unit vector normal to the given plane surface. Okay, this formula you have to use to calculate E1 bar and E2 bar. So E1 bar is equal to rho s1, this is rho s1 divided by 2 epsilon 0, and this is an cap. So how this an cap is minus x cap here, we will check. And E2 bar is equal to rho s2, this is rho s2 divided by 2 epsilon 0 ay cap. So why ay cap we used here, that we will discuss. Okay. So rho s1, by putting this value here, rho s1, 2 is as it is, and epsilon 0, I told you epsilon 0, you straight away use this formula, 10 raised to minus 9 divided by 36 pi, because it will save your time, it will easy to compute the answer. Okay, and the answer is minus 180 pi ax cap. In this case also the answer is 270 pi ay cap. Now the question remaining is why we took minus ax cap and here why ay cap we took. Because here in general formula what is mentioned? In general formula you have to use an cap. An cap. So an cap is a unit vector which is perpendicular or normal to the given surface. So first of all we need to take consider the diagram. The diagram is shown in this particular slide. The first surface is kept at x equal to 2. So x equal to 2 surface is where it is cutting the x-axis. It is the cutting the x-axis at 2. So suppose this is my x-axis, this is y-axis. So x equal to 2, if I cut x equal to 2 in this way, then which is the perpendicular direction to this plane surface, which is perpendicular direction? This is x-axis cutting at x equal to 2. So ax cap will be the direction for this. Okay, y plus ax cap, if your point is lying ahead of this, then you have to use plus ax cap. If your point is behind this plane surface, then you have to use minus ax cap. So where is your point is? The point is 1, 1, minus 1, where you want to find out electric field intensity. So 1, 1, 1, minus 1, where is 1, 1, minus 1? If the plane surface is at x equal to 2, then 1, 1, minus 1, so this would be here, somewhere here. That means your point is on the back side of this plane surface. It is not on the front side of this x equal to 2. So as the point is on back side of this plane surface, that means force or E bar will be in the back direction along x axis. That means that's why the an cap will be minus ax cap in this case. Okay, similarly why you took this ay cap? Because the plane surface, second plane surface, is at y equal to minus 3. Where is y equal to minus 3? Suppose this is your x axis, this is y and this is z. So positive y axis, negative y axis is somewhere here. So y equal to minus 3 will be here and your point is ahead of, in front of that point. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 1 is somewhere here and your surface, second surface, is here. So obviously this charge surface will exert force in this direction, and this direction is plus ay cap. If your point is on the back side of this surface, then you have to use minus ay cap. So that's why here you find plus ay cap is taken. Okay, you understood this calculation, and the remaining calculation is very simple. Only you have to decide which direction to put here. Otherwise, using this formula is very simple. Now third formula, E3 bar is what? E3 bar is a electric field intensity due to line charge. What is that line charge? Rho L is given, 10 pi nano coulomb. Okay, location of this line charge is x equal to 0 and z equal to 2. So which formula you can use? You can use this particular formula, rho L upon 2 epsilon 0 r ar cap. So rho L is given, 2 pi is constant, epsilon 0 is 10 raised to minus 9 divided by 36 pi, and this r you have to take. So what exactly this r is? R is a distance. Remember, every time in each of the formula of E bar and D bar in this electrostatics, whenever R is mentioned here, and this R is also mentioned here, AR cap, this is nothing but this R. This R is nothing but a distance vector from given charge to the given point. Distance vector from the charge to the given point. So this formula you can write in this manner also. E bar is equal to rho L 2 pi epsilon 0 r a r cap. So this can be the general formula of E bar. Okay, and rho l is given generally 2 pi epsilon 0 is constant, so only you have to find out r and ar cap. What is this r? R is a magnitude of r bar. So what is r bar? Suppose your charge is somewhere here. Suppose this is your charge q or rho l. Suppose this is your line charge, this is rho l. Okay, from this line charge, charge is distributed on it, on this line, that's why it is a line charge. And your point is somewhere here, point P, where you want to find out this E bar. So R bar is nothing but, this R bar is nothing but, draw a vector from this, this is your point. So draw a vector from given charge to the given point where you want to find out E bar. So this is your R bar. R bar is a displacement vector or distance vector from given charge to the given point. And what is AR cap? What is this R now? R is a magnitude of this R bar. And what is AR cap? AR cap is a unit vector along this R bar. So this is unit vector AR cap, whose magnitude is 1. So this is your unit vector. And this is total R bar, distance vector. Distance vector of given point from the given charge. Remember this. So this is a formula we obtained with the help of derivation, considering certain assumptions. That's why we obtained r, small r, and this ar cap. But general formula of E bar due to infinite line charge is this. This is the general formula, rho l upon 2 pi epsilon 0 r ar cap. So each time rho l is given, this three terms are constant, only you have to find out R bar, and from this R bar you will get this magnitude, and from this R bar and magnitude you will get this unit vector. This we already covered in the previous lectures, how to find out unit vector and magnitude from a vector. So here we obtained E1 bar and E2 bar. Now how to obtain E3 bar? Okay, E3 bar, what is the location of line is given? Location of line is x equal to 0 and z equal to 2. So I will simplify this. X equal to 0, suppose this is the line whose coordinates are x equal to 0 and z equal to 2, na? Z equal to 2, yes, z equal to 2. And z equal to 2. And you want to find out intensity E3 bar at which coordinates? 1, comma 1, comma I think minus 1, correct? 1, 1, minus 1. So 1, 1, minus 1. Let me check the coordinates again. 1, 1, minus 1. Yes, it is 1, 1, minus 1. So, how to find out R bar from this line? Distance vector of this point from this given charge, you can draw like this. Assume this is a straight line. I could not draw the straight line. So, this is my R bar and this is my AR cap. Okay, so what are the coordinates of this point? 1, 1, minus 1. What is the coordinate of this point now on this line? Coordinate, two coordinates of this line we know, x equal to 0 and z equal to 2. So the two coordinates of this point would also be, x coordinate will be 0 for this point, z coordinate for this point will be 2. But what is the y coordinate of this point? As it is a perpendicular drawn, this is a perpendicular drawn from the charge to the point. So the ultimately this y coordinate of this point, whatever it may be, it will be the y coordinate of, this will be the y coordinate of this point now. So what are the coordinates of this point now? 0, 1, 2. So we are having the coordinate of this point as well as this point. So therefore very easily we can find out this R bar. So how will you find out R bar? r bar is equal to, r bar is a vector, distance vector of given point, which point? 1, 1, minus 1. So the distance vector is from this charge to the point, okay? So the second coordinate, this arrow is somewhere here. That means this coordinates minus this coordinates, you will get r bar. That means distance vector of given point. So second coordinates are 1 minus 0 will be, 1 minus 0 will be 1 x cap. Then 1 minus 1 ay cap, that means 0 ay cap, okay, 0 ay cap. And this minus 1 minus 2 will be minus 3 az cap. So this is the distance vector of given point, or distance vector of given point. Okay, so r bar we obtained here, r bar is equal to minus 3 az cap plus ax cap. You understood this? Okay, so how will you find out the magnitude of this? Magnitude can be obtained by taking a square root. Square of 1, here is a 1, so 1 square is 1, plus 3 square, minus 3 square, plus 9. So 1 plus 9 will be 10. Yes. And unit vector ar cap will be, ar cap will be equal to divide the vector by its magnitude. You will get, divide the vector, vector, what is vector? This is vector. Divide this vector by its magnitude, you will get unit vector. Now this formula you can use. Which is this formula? This is the, this was the formula of this derivation, and this is the general formula. Rho l upon 2 pi epsilon 0 r ar cap. Now put magnitude here, direction here, these things are given. So by doing the calculation again for this third case, you put here rho l, you put here rho l is given 10 pi nano. What is the rho l is given? Rho l is given to be 10 pi nano coulomb per meter. So 10 pi into 10 raised to minus 9, 10 raised to minus 9 divided by 2 pi epsilon 0 into what? Into r. What is r? What is r? Square root of 1 upon square root 10 into ar cap is this total ar cap. So by doing this calculation, you do this calculation on your calculator, okay, you will find it is found to be 18 pi x cap minus 3 az cap. Now we obtained e1 bar, e2 bar and e3 bar. Adding all these things, we will get total e bar due to all the three charges. Due to all the three charge distributions, we find e bar at this point to be this. This is the answer. Okay. So hope you understood this particular problem on e bar due to line charge, surface charge. So this kind of problem is called as mixed charge distribution problem. That means two or three types of charges are given and you want to find out E bar due to this. So for example, another problem may be there in which they will give you one point charge, one line charge and one surface charge. Due to these three charges, they will ask you to find out E bar. Okay. So with the same logic, you can find out, you can solve that particular problem. In some problem, they may give you two line charges. One surface charge and two point charges. So four charges are given, and with the help of those four charges, find out E bar at certain point. This may be the problem. So mixed charge problem can be of any pattern. So this logic is applicable to all problems. Only you have to remember the formulae. Which are those formulae? Rho s upon 2 epsilon 0 an cap, and the line charge formula is, general formula you have to use, that formula is rho l upon 2 pi epsilon 0 r ar cap. This formula you have to use for line charge distribution, and for point charge distribution you have to use this formula. In all of this, in all these formulas, you have to use only, you have to find out r bar. Once you find out r bar here, or r bar here, you will get ar cap as well as this dimension, all this magnitude. So what exactly r bar here and here is? R bar is nothing but a distance vector of a given point from given charge. Okay, this concept, R bar concept, is applicable to here also, or this R bar concept and unit vector concept is applicable to all most of the problems in electrostatics. So today we will stop here, and in the next lecture we will cover the concept of electric flux density. We will try to solve one problem on electric flux density, okay, and we will start Gauss law, which is the second fundamental law of electrostatics. Thank you.